everybody. It's Lynn from WisconsinGarden.com. And look, we are gardening in December. Today is December 16th, but it's 43 degrees and the sun is shining. So those tasks that I said could wait until spring if you didn't get to them in fall, hey, I can work on them a little bit for at least today and get a little bit more done. And I was particularly concerned about my iris because this year had been a very difficult year with the iris borer. And I thought maybe we're gonna lose all of our iris, but iris are tough. And if you at least make an attempt when you see that there is something that's bothering them and you make an attempt to get rid of it or take out all the old stuff, they will try to come back. What I'm doing today is I'm going under this leaf mulch. Now this mulch just blew here by itself, which is fine. Oh, I see part of our siding is here too. But I'm going down here and I want to get to the root of everything to see what's happening. Okay, so I see this one has new sprouts. Now these sprouted since summer and I'm taking off all these old ones. Anything that looks like it has brown on it, I don't want.
And I'm about removing the leaves.
Taking those off. You're getting ahead of me, Sonny.
Okay, well, I'm just asking.
Okay, so after I've seen, you know, whether there are old leaves left, that's why I didn't do it first, because I want to see where those roots are. Now, don't be disturbed with all of this white fuzzy stuff. That was just part of the building process on the house. Okay. So now that I think I have all the leaves, and I'm collecting the leaves wherever I see them and getting rid of them, I'm going to take my scissors and just cut them off as far down as I can go.
Even the new growth, huh?
Even the new growth, yep. Now, the thought is that if you can get as much cleaned up as possible, the iris borers won't have any place to start. So that's what I'm doing. Okay, and anywhere I see old brown iris leaves, off they come. Now when I get done, I'll just put these leaves back where they were as a little blanket for the winter. Now come spring, all these leaves will be gone because you don't want soggy iris roots. That for sure they will not like. But for now, for winter, it adds as a blanket, and that way when the soil freezes at night and then thaws during the day, it's the blanket that saves the roots. Now this soil right here is still pretty pliable. It hasn't actually frozen yet. That's why if you have things that you're going to be planting in the fall, and if you think, oh, maybe it's too late, like garlic or tulips or something, the soil actually isn't frozen yet. In most cases. Now on the north side of the house where it's mostly have been in shade, that is frozen because it's been in the teens already at night here. It just so happens that right now it's in the 40s. It feels like a heat wave. This isn't the fastest job to do, especially with all the leaves in place, but you can see I've made progress. I've cut off the ones that are growing and I'm trying to keep up with the tops that I cut off, but every now and again I'll look back and say, oh, I forgot to cut that one off, like that one right there. But I'll get to that one when I get to the ones behind it. Now once I'm done, I'll put these leaves back on, like I said, as a blanket, and everything that I'm cutting off will go in the garbage, not the compost. I don't want to take the risk of introducing iris borers into good compost that I might be putting elsewhere in the yard. So this will go in the garbage. Come spring, all these leaves will be braked off and put over around the bushes. But for now, it's been a treat to be able to be out here. So I'm taking full advantage of it.
Yes, you are.
I have one more to go. Sitting right there, almost in the middle.
Oh no, Mr. Bell.
Well, to the best of my ability, I've gotten all the old leaves and all the leaves that I've cut off. I've picked them up as best I could. And now I'm going to be pushing all these leaves back on them again, like I said, as a blanket. Come spring, all the leaves will come off because iris don't like to have wet feet, and all of these leaves would have wetness being held in. Now, that's not to say that they won't benefit from these leaves in the winter, not only as an insulation, but also they will be composting some during the winter, and so they will have the benefit of that compost. As I was also saying, iris are really, really tough plants. Now, as I was pulling things up, I found this little guy who's been desperately working. You can see that this whole part at some point was attacked by the borer, and yet because they're so tenacious, it has started to grow away from where that borer had eaten out all the rest of this rhizome. So I'm going to plant this one back. I'm not going to plant it right in the middle just in case there's still somebody in there, but I will plant it and at least give it a chance. So let me go over there. Since I don't have a trowel with me, this will be my trowel. And because iris don't need to go in very deeply, doesn't have to be very deep hole, but you see that the soil is not frozen. The very top of it might be, but the rest isn't. It's very cold to kneel on. That's why I was using that bench, because it's like kneeling on ice bags. But this bench was better than kneeling on that ground. Again, all of this will go in the garbage. All these old leaves. But all of these leaves are just going to go back in. Now when I come out of the house, I don't have to feel so badly looking over here and seeing some iris up and some iris down. They're all bedded in for the winter, and I'm very happy. And next spring I can take care of the other beds of iris that I didn't get to yet. But we just wanted to thank everybody so much for watching us this past year. We have had such wonderful comments and encouragement and support for everybody that's watched from not only the United States but also 132 countries. So we would like to express our Merry Christmas to those of you that celebrate Christmas, and Happy Kwanzaa, Happy Hanukkah, and just a plain old happy holidays to everybody. And we hope that you have a wonderful, prosperous, healthy new year. Thank you so much for watching. If you like this video, the last one probably of me digging in the dirt for the soil, excuse me, for this year, please give us a thumbs up. And if you'd like to become part of our garden conversation, click that little subscribe button right there and you'll become part of our garden family. Thank you so much. We appreciate it. Happy holidays.
Happy holidays.
Connect with us on YouTube.